Welcome to Lesson 5, which roughly covers pages 38 to 45 of the Automate the Boring Stuff with Python textbook. Now that we know about Boolean values, comparison operators, and Boolean operators, we can start looking at flow control statements. The simplest flow control statements are if and else. Open up a new file editor window by clicking on File, New File, and enter the following code. Name equals Alice, if name equals equals Alice, colon, print, hi Alice, and then go back to the original indentation and type print done. I'm going to save this as ifExample.py and press F5 to run it. You can see that this code prints out hi Alice and done. So let's take a look at the if statement first. Here's a flowchart diagram for it. The expression in the if statement is called a condition. Condition is just a name for an expression in a flow control statement, but technically a condition and an expression are the same thing. If the condition in an if statement evaluates to true, the execution enters the indented code that follows. If the condition is false, the execution skips the indented code. There's a great visualization tool at pythontutor.com that can show us what's happening in this program. I'm just going to copy and paste this program, and then click Visualize Execution. We can click forward to step through the program one line at a time. So first, Alice is assigned to the name variable, then the condition is checked, and it does evaluate to true, so the execution enters this indented code and prints out, hi Alice, and then finally it leaves the block of this indented line of code and executes print done. So let's go back and change this slightly. I'm going to change this so that Bob is assigned to name. You can see that this condition evaluates to false now, so the line of code after it is skipped, and only done is printed. This indented code is called a block. A block is made up of lines of code that are indented at the same level. The indentation is how Python tells what part is inside the if statement's block and what isn't. A block begins when the indentation increases and ends when the indentation returns to its previous level. Blank lines are ignored for the sake of looking at what is in or not in the block. So this is how you can tell that print hi Alice is in a block, because its indentation is increased compared to the previous line. Here's a small game program that I wrote. You don't have to pay attention to the code, just look at the indentation and you can tell where blocks begin and end. So you can tell here the indentation has increased, so this has started a new block, and then the indentation returns back to normal here, so that's the end of the block. This is the complete block. Right here you can tell a new block has started, and then the indentation has increased again on this line, so this is a block inside of this block. And then the indentation returns to its previous level, so this continues on with the previous block. And then the indentation returns back to zero here, so that's the end of this block. This is all one block, it just contains another block inside of itself. And then looking on, you can see that this is also a block, it just contains this block, this one line block here, and this one line block here. And then another block begins right here. Blocks are also sometimes called clauses, but just like how condition is just another name for an expression, they're the same thing. And as a nice reminder, new blocks begin only after statements that end with a colon, like in the if statement in our previous program. You can also check it out right here. Here's a colon, and it begins a new block here. Here's another colon in this statement, it begins a new block. This colon shows that a new block is starting. In our name equals equals Alice example, if the condition was false, nothing happened, but we can use an else statement so that code runs specifically when a condition is false. Let's create a new program and type in the following code. Password equals swordfish, if password equals equals swordfish, colon, print, access granted, and hit backspace to get rid of that indentation. And type else colon, print, wrong password. And save this as if else example. In plain English, this reads as if password is equal to swordfish, print access granted, or else print wrong password. Let's copy and paste this into the online Python tutor tool. If the condition is true, then the if block is executed and the else block is skipped. But if we set it so that the condition will be false, then the if block is skipped and the else block is executed. One and only one of the blocks will be executed. So the flowchart for this program would look something like this. You can see that any path from start to end will go through one and only one of the blocks. So with the if-else statements, one of two blocks is executed, but you might have a case where you want one of many possible blocks to execute. The elif statement is an else-if statement. It lets you provide as many additional conditions to check as you need. Open a new file editor window and enter the following code. Name equals Bob, age equals 3000, if name equals equals Alice, print hi Alice, elif age is less than 12, print you are not Alice kiddo, elif age is greater than 2000, print unlike you, Alice is not an undead immortal vampire. Elif age is greater than 100, print you are not Alice Granny. Save this as if elif example, and then let's run this program. We can copy and paste this into the online Python tutor tool to see what exactly is happening. Here, the string Bob is assigned to name, the integer 3000 is assigned to age, and so now we're at the if statement. This condition is checked and it's false, so it skips that block. Then this elif statement has its condition checked. It's also false, so we skip that. And then here, this is the first true condition that we found, so the execution enters inside of this block. Prints that out, and then it just skips all of the other conditions. You can have as many elif statements follow an if statement as you need, but the order of the elif statements does matter. The execution enters the first block that has a true condition. The rest of the conditions won't even be checked. You can also add an else statement to the end of the chain of elif statements. The else statements block will execute if all of the previous conditions have been false. One last thing about flow control statements. Sometimes you might see code like this. This condition is kind of weird. The name variable is set to whatever the user has typed in, but input will be returning a string value, not a Boolean true or false value. But the reason this code works is that the conditions can use truthy and falsy values. Now for strings, the blank string is a falsy value. If a condition evaluates to the blank string, it's considered to be the same as the false Boolean values. All the other non-blank string values are truthy values. Let's try running this code. Enter a name, I can type in Alice, and it says thank you for entering a name. Since a non-blank string like Alice is truthy, then this was considered to be a true condition, so it entered this block of code. But if I run this again and enter nothing, the blank string is considered a falsy value, so this condition is considered to be false. And so this block of code was executed. While this code works and it's a nice shortcut, in general it's better to be more explicit. You should change this line to be something more like if name does not equal the blank string. For integers, the value 0 is the falsy value and every other integer value is truthy, and the 0.0 floating point value is falsy and everything else is truthy. But you can use the bool function to return an equivalent Boolean value of whatever value you pass it. This is kind of like the string and int functions that we've seen before. So if we pass 0 to bool, we can see that's a falsy value. Bool returns false. But if we pass any other integer, it returns true. We can do this with string values as well. Hello is a truthy value, whereas the blank string is a falsy value. To recap, an if statement can be used to conditionally execute code, depending on whether or not the if statement's condition is true or false. An elif, that is, an else-if statement, can follow an if statement, and its block executes if the condition is true and all the previous conditions have been false. An else statement comes at the end. Its block is executed if all the previous conditions have been false. And finally, the values 0, 0.0, and the empty string are considered to be falsy values. When used in conditions, they're considered to be the same as the false Boolean values. You can always see which for yourself which values are truthy or falsy by passing them to the bool function.